Hey guys, Blue OJ Leader here. With Thomas and Friends going for well over 75 years, there's bound to be a lot of episodes, plenty of which that don't get talked about. So I thought it might be fun to go through every single Thomas and Friends episode. Yes, every single one. At least from the classic series. Now that might seem impossible, considering that we may not have to go through about 600 episodes. Well, first of all, that's why I'm only talking about the classic series for now. Second of all, to make sure that this video doesn't go for hours, I'm going to go through the episodes relatively quickly, probably one or two sentences each. And last of all, this is all my opinion, so feel free to disagree. Anyway, starting with season 1, here is my opinion on every classic Thomas and Friends episode. It's a very good first episode. It's good. It's kind of funny. It's a good part two. Honestly, this episode was so overplayed on DVDs to the point where I stopped caring about it. It's good. Good, but overshadowed by The Adventure Begins. It's pretty good. It's very good. It's good. It's the basic Thomas episode, but it's not as bad as some people say. It's kind of funny. I like it. Good, but similar issue with Thomas's train. It's good. It's alright. It's pretty good. I honestly really like this episode. Fantastic. The visuals and music are amazing. I hold a lot of nostalgia for this episode, so I still consider it a favorite. I like it. It's pretty good. I like it a lot. It's pretty good. It's good. Aside from having a more White Christmassy setup, I don't know why they couldn't have just done Mrs. Kindly's Christmas instead. And my overall opinion on season 1 is pretty good. There's nothing I really dislike about this season. It's true classic Thomas and a near-perfect season. Now season 2. I like it. I think it's pretty funny. It's decent. It's good. I really love this episode. I do not like this episode. It's rather boring. The pacing is very slow and a lot of the scenes feel very dragged out. This is my least favorite classic Thomas episode. It's pretty good. It's pretty good. Plus, Ringo Starr's quiet line is priceless. It's very good. It's good. It's very good. It's very good. Good cliffhanger episode. Very epic chase, but I do think we needed a proper part 4. Similar issues with Thomas and Trevor, but I don't hate it. It's pretty good. It's good. It's very good. It's pretty good. It's good, but I do think we needed Ball Eyes. I think it's pretty funny. It's good. My personal favorite episode. I love Edward's exploit. Edward is at his best, and it's an example of a near-perfect episode. It's spooky and fun. It's pretty good. Better than the last Christmas special, but not by much. And my overall opinion on season 2 is my favorite season of Thomas. The episodes in this season were just amazing, for the most part. It really felt like an improvement from season 1, and it will be hard to top. Now season 3. I like the additions they made to this story. It should have come before Percy takes a plunge, but still really good. It's decent. It's good. It's good. I do not care for this episode. I kinda like it. It's good, but a little overrated. This is my comfort episode. I love Henry's Forest. It's decent. Not a fan. Cool nighttime scenes. It's good. It's good. It's good. I do not care for this episode. It's good. Aside from the ending, it's a little overrated. I do not care for this episode. Not a very good adaptation, but good overall. I love this episode. It's pretty good. It's good. It's pretty good. Not a fan. The US version got pretty screwed up, but even ignoring that, it's still probably the weakest Christmas special from the classic series. And my overall opinion on season 3 is, decent. I mean, I know people liked this season, but a lot of the episodes aren't very good, and it's personally my least favorite classic Thomas season. Sorry. Now season 4. I really liked this episode. The recap is annoying, but a good part 2. It's pretty good. It's pretty good. It's pretty good. It's... okay. It's good. It's good. It's good. It's good. It's pretty good. It's pretty good. It's... good. It's really good. It's overrated. It's good. It's good, but forgettable. It's pretty good. It's really good. It's really good. It's pretty good. It's good. It's good. It's pretty good. Not a fan. Yeah, not a fan. And my overall opinion on season 4 is... good. I know this is another season people tend to really like, but none of the episodes felt like obvious favorites. There were a lot of it's goods in there. But then again, nothing was god-awful. Now season 5. I like this episode. It's... good. I like this episode. It's really funny. It's decent. It's a little too inconsistent with the story. It's good. It's... not a fan. Underrated episode here. I love Put Upon Percy. I really liked this episode. It's good and spooky. It's good. It's dark, but good. It's good. It's pretty good. It's good. It's good. It's good. Not a fan. It's kind of funny. Bland in some ways, but still good. I do not care for this episode. I like this episode. It's pretty spooky and good. I was terrified by this episode as a kid, and now I like this episode. It's pretty good compared to the other winter episodes. And my overall opinion on season 5 is... there is a reason this is the overall fan favorite season. I do think people tend to overlook some obvious duds of episodes, but I still consider it my second favorite season behind 2. Now season 6. It's pretty good. It's pretty good. It's pretty good and kind of funny. It's pretty good. It's pretty good. It's really good. It's really good. I like this episode. It's really good. It's pretty good. It's pretty good. It's really good. Not a fan. Not a fan. It's pretty good. Not a fan. I really liked this episode. It's really good. It's good-ish. It's really good. It's good. I really liked this episode and it's very funny. I really liked this episode. It's pretty good. Not a fan. It's good, and I like the concept of it. And my overall opinion on season 6 is... I understand its major problems, particularly the visuals, US narration, and the weaker stories. But there are a lot of hidden gems in this season, and I'd go as far to say that I like it almost as much as season 5. Yeah. And finally, season 7. It's pretty good. It's really good. It's pretty good. I do not like how Scarlowe is used in this episode. I think the concept is okay, but Scarlowe was just not the right choice. It probably should have been Sir Handel or something. It's... not a fan. It's decent. I actually kind of liked this episode. It's good. It's good. It's... decent. It's good. It's pretty good. It's good. I liked this episode. I liked this episode. It's good. It's good. I liked this episode. It's pretty good. It's... decent. It's pretty good. I actually kind of liked this episode. I liked this episode. It's decent, but forgettable. I actually kind of liked this episode. It's really good. And my overall opinion on season 7 is... somewhere between 5 and 6. There are some stinkers in this season, but a lot higher highs. It improves on the issues from season 6 and is pretty underrated. I honestly like this season as much as season 5. So, sue me, I guess. And that is my opinion on every classic Thomas and Friends episode. In case you didn't know, this video was partially inspired by the Ouroboros' opinion on every Pokemon video. Go check that out if you want. But it's definitely more PG compared to my channel. If you want me to do the other eras and seasons of Thomas and Friends, let me know and I'll get to work on them soon. But for now... so that's going to be all for this video, guys. Be sure to leave a like if you enjoyed it, subscribe if you haven't already, and let me know in the comments what you thought of this video. But that's all for now, guys. This is the Blue OJ Leader, and I'll see you later.